Hello students, in this part of the video we will talk about nucleus. Right, we know that nucleus is also known as the controlling center of the cell. So this nucleus is a dense, it is a dense spherical body located near the center of the cell. Right, it is present in the center of the cell. Though it is not present in the center in the plant cell, because in the plant cell the central position is occupied by a large vacuole, right? Otherwise in rest of the cells, like in animal cell, the nucleus is located near the center. Its diameter varies from 10 to 15 micrometer. So it varies in diameter. It can be from 10 to 25 micrometer. It is present in all the cells except RBCs and the CU tubes, right? So we know that mature RBCs do not have a nucleus, and the sieve tubes also lack the nucleus. And the nucleus is well developed in plants and animal cells. If we talk about the eukaryotic cells, the nucleus is very well developed in these eukaryotic cells, like plants and animal cells, right? And if we talk about the prokaryotic cells, like bacteria and blue-green algae, which are also known as cyanobacteria, they are not well developed, or we can say they are underdeveloped in the prokaryotic cells. Right? So if we talk about the number of nucleus present in a cell, so in most of the cells, nucleus is present singly, right? So it is called as uninucleated condition. That means having only one nucleus. But in few types of cells, there are more than one nuclei present, like the skeletal muscle cells. So they have many nuclei in them, and that type of condition is called as syncytic condition. So syncytic condition means presence of more than one nuclei. Nucleus is the singular term, and if we say nuclei, that represents the plural term, right? So if we see the nucleus, its structure looks somewhat like this, right? So nucleus has a double layered covering. There are two coverings present, and these two coverings are called as nuclear membrane. They are called as nuclear membrane. There are two nuclear membrane present, outer and inner nuclear membrane. And these membranes have pores. Okay, there are pores present on the nuclear membrane, and the diameter of these pores are about 80 to 100 nanometer. Right? Inside the nucleus, if we see, there is a colorless dense sap present, and that colorless dense sap is known as nucleoplasm. That is known as nucleoplasm, right? So the nucleoplasm contains round shaped nucleolus. See here in the diagram, this is the nucleolus, okay, which is darkly stained here. This is nucleolus, and it also contains network of chromatin fiber, right? So chromatin fibers are visible here. They are chromatin fibers. Fibers are composed of DNA and histone protein. Do remember that these fibers are composed of histone protein and DNA. These chromatin fibers condense to form chromosomes during cell division. Do remember this thing, that the chromatin fibers are present, which are formed of DNA and histone protein. They are thread-like structures, okay, and they take the form of chromosome during cell division, right? When the cell is to divide, during that time only they take the form of chromosome, okay. They become condensed, they become short, and they take the form of chromosomes during cell division. If we see The structure of DNA, it looks somewhat like this, which is a double helical structure, and the chromosomes contain stretches of DNA called genes. If we talk about what are genes, so genes are the hereditary unit. Okay, genes are the hereditary unit, and we can also say that the functional segment of DNA are called as genes. Right? So genes transfer the hereditary information from one generation to the next. That's why they are termed as hereditary units. So the functional segment of DNA are called as genes, and genes transfer the hereditary information from one generation to the next. Okay? So if we talk about DNA, which is a polynucleotide and it has a double helical structure which is formed of DNA, and histone proteins are present. You see in the purple color, these are the histone octamers. Okay, so it contains DNA and histone protein. So this is the chromatin fiber which we were talking about, and they take the form of chromosome at the time of cell division. Right, so the functions of the nucleus, we can conclude that nucleus control all the cell activities like metabolism, protein synthesis, growth, and cell division. Nucleolus, which is present inside the nucleus, which is darkly stained structure, the nucleolus synthesize RNA to constitute ribosomes. Okay, so we can say that nucleolus is the factory of ribosomes, and nucleus also store hereditary information in the form of genes. So I hope what is nucleus, its structure and function is clear to you. Thank you.